All right, you guys, good afternoon. Sorry for the delay in that. Naturally, when I wanted to start the video, Facebook decided to pause or wouldn't let me load. So anyways, here we are. Happy Tuesday. I hope you guys are having a good day. If you joined us for morning mindfulness, welcome back. So good to see you again. And yeah, we're moving right along with this class. Just offering a variation on movement. So this one is focused on strength and endurance. If you ever join our morning classes, you know that's a little bit more of gentle stretching, some breath work, trying to quiet the chatter a little bit in our minds. And this one is really just focused on building up that heart rate, getting a little bit of a sweat going, and focusing on strength and endurance of our bodies. So I'll get right into the quote or the tidbit that I like to share with you guys. The one for today says, the least movement is of importance to all nature. The entire ocean is affected by a pebble. The least movement is of importance to all nature. The entire ocean is affected by a pebble. And I think this one is so important because it sums up the fact that it doesn't matter how big or how small, how perfect or imperfect. It's not about quantity or measuring what your movement is. It's just the fact that you move, right? So everyone's going to show up a little bit different. Everyone's going to present a little bit different, and that's okay. All the chair exercises that we offer they're basically a suggestion, right? Like, I'm going to offer that guidance, but if it makes more sense for you to do something different or modify in one way, that's okay. You know, if I say 10 reps and I do 20 and you only do 5, that's all right too. If there's certain exercises that you need to pass on or modify entirely, it's okay. The littlest motion is going to be beneficial for you. And even with that motion, if it's not physical, maybe it's energetic. Right? If there is an activity or an exercise that you are not able to complete today for whatever reason, maybe it's just energy or it's a physical ability or whatever it is, maybe you just don't want to today. Maybe it's the energetic motion that you're doing. Maybe just showing up and being a part of it is where your movement is today. So yeah, let it be what it needs to be for you in this moment. And we'll keep plugging right along, right? So try not to compare, let it be what it needs to be for you and know that every little bit counts. So we'll go ahead, we'll get started. Our playlist is, yesterday it was all Earth, Wind, and Fire. We're just gonna kind of stick with that this week, but it's a little bit of a variation. So it's all music based off of Earth, Wind, and Fire. So we'll get those tunes going as well and we'll just try to have some fun with it. So. Go ahead, guys, get to your starting position and we'll get this class going. All right, so come to those starting positions. Bring your feet flat to the floor, have your hips heavy, and then feel your spine nice and long. Sit up tall here. I always like to start all movement with a little bit of breath here. So let these breaths be really cleansing. And then feel free to let out any crud that you don't need. So inhale, pull the breath in. Open mouth, exhale, let it all go. Good. Feel free to really sigh that out heavy. Let out any heat or any anxiety or negativity. Just feel free to breathe it out. Inhale through the nose, body fills. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. Nice job, you guys. Last one. Deep cleansing breath in. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. So, so good. Before we get started, I'm going to give you the water PSA. Make sure you stay hydrated. If at any point you get a little too tired or you feel winded or your heart rate is up a little too high, it's okay. Just slow it down. Take a couple of breaths and make sure you stay hydrated, okay? Good. So the goal here is definitely to focus a little bit more on strength and endurance. So we're going to be moving a little faster, doing some more reps, and like I said, try to have a little fun with it. So All right, here we go, guys. We'll get this music going. Get some more beats happening. Keep the energy up. If you want to spend the next hour dancing, by all means, do you. All right, let's start with the spine here. So sitting up nice and tall, we're going to drop the chin down and lift it back up. Drop it down and lift it back up. Good. Make sure you keep the breath moving. Your muscles and all the tissues are going to need to replenish their oxygen, especially as we turn up the pace a little bit here. Nice job, you guys. Way to start strong. We're going to aim for 10, but if you've ever joined me, you know counting's not the strong suit. So we kind of go until I think we should switch. If you only want to do 10, feel free to stop there. If you want to do more, keep going. Nice job, you guys. Just keep that breath flowing and the body moving. Oh, nice work. Go ahead, come on back to that starting position. And now we're going to take our neck side to side. So gently dropping the ear to the right, up to the middle, and to the left. Nice work, you guys. And again, keep in mind that everything I'm offering is just a suggestion. Make sure you modify according to your body, staying safe, staying stable, and avoiding any added pain or injury. Nice job, you guys. Keeping the breath going. If at any point you become winded or short of breath, make sure you slow down or stop altogether and gather your bearings. All right, one more each side. Nice job, you guys. Come on back to center. I miss Bill. Bill, if you're out there, you were my counter. You actually kept me in line. I'm back to being by myself, and you know, 10 is give or take. We'll go with that. All right, you guys, let's go ahead. Let's get our shoulders into it now. So we want to roll those shoulders up and back down. Roll the shoulders up and back down. Nice job, you guys. Keep the breath moving. Maybe you switch directions halfway through, going forward and backwards. Good work, you guys. Whatever feels good here, just get a little motion in the neck, the shoulder girdle. Nice work, you guys. All right, come on back to center. Bring your feet flat again. Make sure your hips are heavy into the chair. Feel your spine nice and tall. Relax the arms and shoulders down. And then go ahead and place your hands right on your lap here. So we're going to round forward here. And I really want you to focus on pulling all the muscles in your front body together, right? So you might feel a stretch in the backside of your body. That's okay. That's just going to be kind of an added bonus, a little bit of a side effect from the motion of pulling everything forward. Good. So really start to engage those muscles in your abdomen, all through the chest, the pec, even a little bit in your neck and throat here. Good. And then come back to center. Round forward. Squeeze all those muscles in. Pull in the low belly. Good. Come back to seated. Nice job, you guys. You're doing so good. Keep that breath moving. Really focus on engaging and activating those muscles. Awesome work. Couple more, just like that. Nice work, you guys. One more. Pull everything in. Get those muscles nice and tight, activated here, and then come on back to seated. Awesome work, you guys. You should start to feel that spine loosening up, get the muscles a little warm, might feel the blood flowing a little. We're definitely turning the energy up here. All right, this next one we're going to focus on our back body, right? So all the muscles, the whole length of the spine, lumbar, thoracic, even cervical. We want to get our shoulder blades engaged, our traps, everything on the backside of our body here. Now, you might feel a stretching across the front of the body. That's okay. No different than when we were rounding forward and our back stretched. This time we're pulling back and our front's going to stretch a little bit. But the focus is to really engage all those muscles behind us, right? So if you have armrests on your chair, you can place your hands right on them. You can bring your hands to the seat beneath you, or you can even grab the chair back behind you. So then we'll just start to pull everything back, squeeze all those muscles, feel the whole length of the spine curling towards itself, and relax. Good, squeeze everything together, feel the shoulder blades pulling, feel the spinal muscles engage, and relax. Good. Maybe you dance a little bit, you got Stevie Wonder in the background. Fun fact, this is my parents' wedding song, of all songs. But if you knew my parents, it would, you know, it would fit them. They like to dance. I like to say that they gave me a little bit of my rhythm. Good. Pull those muscles together, squeeze everything in here, and keep that breath moving. Nice job, you guys. One more, just like that. Pull all the muscles in, tighten everything in the back of your body, and relax. Whew. Nicely done, you guys. Let's take a breath here to reset. Inhale through the nose. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. Awesome work. If you have some water and you want to take a second to hydrate, please do so. Nice job. All right, you guys, let's move on here. We are going to continue down the shoulders through the entire length of the arms and out the hands and fingers. So this first one is going to be flexion and extension at the shoulder. So it's essentially lifting up towards the ceiling and then back down a little bit towards your back. So a couple options here with the hand grips. You can take your fingers in between one another. That's just gonna get a little bit more range and mobility in the hands. You can take a cupped grip, clasping over one another. You can always utilize the strength of one hand to assist the other. And then of course, you can always just use one hand. So wherever you're at, take it nice and slow. We wanna make sure that we're not jarring or cranking on the shoulders too much, but it should be an easy flowing motion. So come to that starting position, have your hips heavy, spine long, take the grip of your choice, and then inhale, start to lift over your head, and exhale back down. Good, this is flexion, lifting forward and up, extension down and back. Nice job, you guys. And it doesn't matter how high you're getting with this, maybe you're just coming to shoulder height and back down, right? It's a little bit of a shorter range, but it's still within range. So it's still flexion forward, extension backwards. Nice job, you guys. Keep that moving, keep the breath flowing. And tune in to your body. Do you need to take a break? Do you need to take a couple of breaths? Or do you just need to slow down a little bit? If you want, you can even speed up wherever you're at. Let's do one more here. Reach all the way as high as you can go. And then wherever you end up, stretch a little higher and then go side to side. Good. Getting motion at the shoulder girdle, feeling your sides and your core engage here. Nice job, you guys. Doing so good here. Good. Take another breath in. And then as you exhale, slowly, 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 slowly lower those arms here. Nice job, you guys. Doing so great. All right. We are going to go ahead and move on to motion here at the elbow. So it's flexion and then extension, right? It's essentially a bicep curl. And I'm going to turn to the side so that you can see it a little different. Now, again, you do have those same hand grip options, right? So fingers in between, hands cupped, assisting one arm with the other, or just using the strength of one arm. And so you really want to focus on squeezing those biceps as you lift up, and then squeezing the triceps as you straighten the arms. Good. Allow the upper arm bones just to hang down or rest on a table if you have one. Good. Straightening the arms and then curling them up. Straightening the arms and then curling up. Nice job, you guys. Doing so good. Keep the breath moving. As you're working your muscles, you need to make sure to replenish that oxygen. Maybe you're just doing one arm, or you're assisting the other. Good. Got a good little baseline going here. Know that Papa was a rolling stone. Nice job, you guys. All right, good work. We're gonna go ahead and finish up with that. Do one more, squeeze those muscles in tight, and then release. Awesome work, you guys. Doing so, so good. All right, so I'm gonna grab the notes and gonna come a little closer to you. All right here. So if your arms are tired at all, feel free to shake it out a little bit. We're gonna go ahead and get into motion here at the forearms. So this is pronation and supination. So if you're just doing one arm, it's gonna be palm down and then palm up. Pronation is palm down, supination is palm up. Good. Now if you want, you can use one hand to assist the other. Right, rotating here at the forearm. And then just like the other arm motions, you can also take varied hand grips. So either cupping over one another or fingers in between. All right, and then just back and forth with those forearms, rotating here. Nice job, you guys. Keep that breath moving, smooth and steady. You're doing so good. You look great out there. Awesome job. If you're anything like me, there might be some snap, crackle, and pops going on, but that's okay as long as there's no pain. And making sure that you're steady and stable. Nice work, you guys. All right, go ahead, shake that out, let it go. Awesome work. Okay, we're now going to move into flexion and extension of the wrist. Right, so flexion is going to be pulling those muscles forward. Extension is taking that hand back. Good. And maybe you're using your other hand to assist. So you're pulling it forward and then bringing it back. Good. Pulling it forward and then maybe taking it back. Nice job, you guys. If you're doing both hands at the same time, either fingers in between one another or cupped, and then same thing, backwards and forwards, just alternating the wrist motion here. Nice work, you guys. Doing so good. Really getting those muscles to engage on each side of the hand. Nice job. All right, go ahead, shake it out here. Whew. I'm sure if Bill's out there counting, he's like, Marianne, you're at 20. Give it a rest. All right, let's go ahead and move on to the next one. So we are going to do finger opposition or thumb opposition, however you want to call it. So we're taking the thumb pad and we're pushing it against the finger pad of each of the fingers. So starting with the pinky and then release. Move on to the ring finger and then release. Middle finger and release. Pointer finger and release. Nice job. Repeat, so pinky and ring and middle and pointer. Nice work, you guys. If you're doing both hands, same thing. Pinky, release, ring finger, pushing nice and hard, release, middle finger, release, and then pointer finger, release. Nice job, you guys. If you are using one hand to assist the other, no different, right? So just pull those fingers in towards one another and release. Good. Pull in the ring finger and release. I'm trying to show you guys this on camera is a little hard. Good. You're doing so good, you guys. Let's finish out strong. One more set. Ring finger. Pinky finger. My goodness. Release. Now ring finger. Release. Middle finger. Release. Pointer finger. And release. Oh, nice job, you guys. If you need to, feel free to shake out the fingers. Massage them out a little bit. Just give them a little bit of a break. All right, so we are moving on to our last one for the hands and fingers. So we're going to start by making fists. Just real tight. Clench those fingers in. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. And then open up nice and wide. Good. Squeeze everything in nice and tight. Pull those fingers in. Pull, 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 pull. And release. So good. Squeeze everything in and let go. Couple more. Squeeze. Get everything nice and tight and release. You guys are doing so good. Really feel those muscles curl in, activate and engage, and then open up. Couple more, just like that, you guys. If you're using one hand to assist the other, right, you might just curl that hand over. And then open it up. Good. Curl it over. And open it up. Curl it over. And open it up. So good, you guys. Let's do one more just for good measure. Pull everything in. And open it up. So good. You guys are doing great. Feeling okay out there? All right. Feel free to shake out your hands. Take a little breather. I'm going to head back to the chair and we'll move forward with legs and core. All right, you guys, make sure to take a sip of the water if you need. Good. Let's go ahead and take a breath to reset here. Restore our oxygen. So deep inhale, pull the breath in. Open mouth, exhale, let the breath go. Nice work, you guys. All right, so we're gonna move into our legs and our core here. Couple options throughout all of this, right? If you really wanna activate that core, sit up nice and tall, keep your spine away from the back of your chair and engage all the muscles in the front and the back of your spine here. You, of course, can always have the option of laying your spine back. That's going to give you a little bit more support while you're activating your legs. But you still want to keep that low belly nice and tight. Keep it engaged. All right, so we're going to start with our quads here. Fire those up, and we'll start with the right leg. This is extension of the knee. Squeeze everything in your quads. And release. Nice job. Next one, squeeze the quads here, lifting everything back up and let go. Nice job, you guys. Extending at the leg here, activate the front of the quad and release. Doing so good. Squeeze those thighs and bring them back down. Good. Now again, a couple options here. Keeping your spine nice and upright. If you need a little bit of support, you can hold onto the chair beneath you or lay all the way back with your seat. Onto your seat, I should say. And maybe you're also just focusing on one leg, right? Using this other hand to assist. Maybe you even grab onto your pant leg and pull it up. Just really trying to lift that leg as best you can. And maybe it's just down here. Maybe the goal is to simply lift it up off the floor, right? Every little bit counts. Let it be what your body needs for today. Nice job, you guys. So good. Feel free to take a breath to reset. The next one that we're going to do is going to pump it up just a little bit. It will be a little harder. So again, come to your starting position. Have your core nice and strong. Feel all those muscles in your belly and your back engaged. And then we'll start with the right leg. Get it as straight as you can. Squeeze the quad muscle. And then we'll start to rotate at the hip. You can start by going clockwise, maybe get the ankle involved. Keep that breath moving. The harder the exercises get, the more oxygen you're going to need. Nice job, you guys. Maybe take a break here, let it rest, because then we're going to turn around and do counterclockwise. So you want to make sure you rotate in both directions. This is a little too tough. You can always bend the knee. It's going to essentially lighten the load of how much weight or force is going to be utilized here. And then, of course, you can always take your back against the back of the chair. Nice job. Maybe your leg is straight, but you're still using the support. So good, you guys. Doing really awesome. All right, let's go ahead, give that leg a rest. Maybe take a deep breath in, and we're gonna switch sides. Good, so if you can, squeeze that thigh as tight as you can, straighten the leg as much as it'll go, and then start to rotate. Going in one direction, maybe getting the ankle involved here. Nice work, you guys. Again, feel free to shorten the length of the leg, if you will, by putting a bend in the knee. And then make sure to switch directions. If you need to take a break, feel free, rest that leg down, and then get started again. Nice job, you guys. So good. Probably starting to feel yourself get a little warmer, feeling those muscles activated. Awesome job. Go ahead, give yourselves a break here. Maybe rest those thighs, give them a little massage. Definitely might start to increase the blood pressure, a little bit of heart rate, a little bit of sweat. Just make sure you're monitoring yourself. Easy enough for me to say. Monitoring yourself through all of this, right? A little bit of raise in heart rate or blood pressure, that's okay, but you want to make sure it's within safe boundaries and that you're not going to cause any other injury or instability. All right, guys, doing so good. Hope you're doing okay out there. I'm gonna turn to the side so I can show you heel raises. So from your starting position, feet start flat on the floor, and then what we want you to do here is push your toes into the ground as you lift those heels up, right? And then relax. Push the toes into the ground as you lift your heels up, and relax. Nice job, you guys. Couple options here. If you want, you can alternate, raising one heel at a time. You always have the option of just focusing on one leg as well. And a couple different ways to support that. You can use your hand to help draw that leg up a little bit, or you can also use the other foot to assist it. need a little bit more resistance, or you want a little bit of a challenge, you can take one or both hands and push it into the knees of the heels that you're raising, right? So you're going to engage the arms, engage the core, and essentially push against yourself here. So you're kind of having a little battle within your own body. That's okay, right? It just should feel nice and engaging throughout your whole body here. Good. Keep that breath moving, smooth and steady. Nice job, you guys. Good. Wherever you're at, go ahead, do a couple more. Awesome job, you guys. All right, let's go ahead and be done with those. You guys are doing so great. Let's move on to marches. So we're going to come back to that starting position. Spine is long, core is engaged, and then we'll alternate lifting our knees up towards the ceiling. Good. And again, this is just one variation. Maybe your hands come out for more of a balance challenge. Maybe you're actually leaning back for a little bit more support. Or perhaps you're just focusing on one leg and maybe using one hand to assist, right? Good. Or maybe you're alternating and then still just assisting one leg. A lot of different options here. Do what's best for you. Honor your body. Nice work, you guys. Also, now that I'm thinking of it, if you want a little bit more of a challenge, just like the heel raises, you can actually push your hands against those knees, right? So a couple different ways to modify, either make it a little easier or a little more challenging. Wherever you're at today. Nice work, you guys. All right, go ahead, take a breath in and a breath out. You guys are doing so, so good. And the next two that we're gonna do are definitely going to kick it up a notch a little bit. Man, my words are not working. Maybe I needed a second cup of coffee today. These next two are going to be a little bit more challenging, so make sure that breath keeps moving and really, really listen to what your body needs. I'm going to turn to the side to show you here. So I'll show you the full expression first, and then we'll go ahead and offer variations. So arms will come up as your spine is long and lifted, have everything engaged here in the front and the back body, and then we're going to lift those legs up. Good. What we should feel is our low belly engage here. And now that my legs are out, I'm thinking we have a couple options here too. You can always bend the knees and lift them a little higher up. Or if your legs are straighter out, maybe it will go a little lower. But you really want to make sure you're avoiding any pain in the low back. Right? Keep your low belly nice and tight. And then maybe you're holding that for 3 seconds, 5 seconds, or even 10 seconds. You're really pushing it. Of course, variations, arms are up, maybe you just lift one leg, right? Focusing on one side of the body and then releasing, maybe switching legs out. Good, maybe you use your hands for a little bit of support here. Good, and then of course, always taking the variation if you need of resting your spine back on the chair and then lifting the legs. Good, and even if your spine is supported, you still want to activate the core, feeling all the muscles in your abdominals engage here. Good, keep the breath moving, slow and steady. You guys are doing so good. I'm gonna turn and show full expression again. Nice job, you guys. One last option, instead of holding, maybe you're alternating and doing reps. Good. Wherever you're at, keep the breath moving, listen to your body. Maybe start to feel a little bit of heat build. Maybe you're perspiring a bit. That is okay. Nice job, you guys. Doing so good. We're on our last one for legs and core. Just do a quick check-in, see how you're feeling, and if you're up for it, finish it off strong. All right, so coming back to that position from our core holds, we're gonna do the exact same posture, but now we're bicycling, right? So paddling those legs as if you're on a bicycle, really feeling that core stay strong, active. Good, and again, lots of variations, right? Maybe you're just pedaling with one leg. Maybe you're alternating. Maybe your hands are down for a little bit more support. And then, of course, your other variation is supporting your back with the chair and continuing to pedal. Nice job, you guys. Keep it going. Good, full expression, one more time. Keep the breath going. You'll start to feel it in the upper thighs, definitely your belly here. Awesome work, you guys. So good, those are definitely not easy. So let's go ahead, take a breath to reset. Clear it all out. The breath is a great way to move some heat. So if you start feeling really warm or you're starting to sweat, take a nice cleansing breath in and then open your mouth and let all that extra heat out. Nice work, you guys. All right, I'm gonna take a sip of water, hydrate. All right, doing so good. We're moving right along, you guys. So the next one we're going to get into is eye exercises, right? So no different than your biceps or your quads or those core muscles. We really want to keep all the muscles in and around the eyes active and engaged. Oops, sorry, you guys. Thought I had my phone on Do Not Disturb. But apparently, whoever is calling me, it looks like it's important. All right, sorry about that, you guys. That is the one challenge of using your phone for the music as well. All right, sorry about that. Let's get back to our eye exercises. So the rule of thumb here is to have your eyes follow the thumb, right? So our first exercise, our head is gonna stay perfectly still, but our eyes are gonna move around in a circle as our thumb moves around. So I'll go ahead and walk you through it. Come to your starting position, sit up nice and tall, bring your thumb straight out in front and keep your eyes on your thumb and then start to move your thumb in clockwise circles. And then follow the thumb with your eyes and only your eyes. So keep that head steady. Keep the breath moving. And get those eyes to move in big, big circles all the way around in their sockets. Nice job, you guys. Let's do about two more just like that. Nice and big, and then we'll come to rest. So listen closely, bring the thumb back to the center, close the eyes, and release the arm. Good, so this is the way that you rest your eye muscles, by closing the eyes. Right now my eye muscles aren't required to move or do anything, and I can just give them that little break that they need. No different than letting your bicep relax after curls or stretching out your core after some holds. All right, you guys, we're gonna do another round of those, except we're gonna move our thumb counterclockwise. So whichever direction you were going, reverse that circle and we'll get it going. Thumb straight out, eyes open, eyes stay directly on the thumb, and now we're going counterclockwise. So good, you guys. Keep that head steady, but eyes are moving.
Nice job, you guys. Getting the full range of motion, really pushing the range of your eyes here. Let's do about two more. Nice and big, big circles with the thumb and the eyes. And then we'll take another rest here in a second. So come on back towards center. Close the eyes, release the hand. Nice job, you guys. So, so good. Resting the eyes, letting everything relax here. Maybe take a couple of breaths while you're resting the arm and the eyes. All right, so the next two sets we're going to do, similar idea, except this time the thumb and our eyes will stay steady, and we're going to move the head around the eyes. So let's go ahead, open those eyes, and I will walk you through it. So thumb comes out, eyes come directly to thumb, and then start to rotate your head side to side while keeping your eyes on your thumb. Good. Going left to right with the head, but keeping those eyes steady, fixated on the thumb in front of you. Nice work, you guys. One more each side. And come back to center, close the eyes, and rest. Ah, nice job, you guys. We're doing so well. We've got one more set. Let's give our eyes a break here. And this next set that we're going to do is, instead of going side to side with the head, we're going to take the head up and down. But again, thumb and eyes stay steady. So let's go ahead, let's finish these eye exercises off. Bring the thumb straight out in front of you. Open the eyes, and then take the head up and down. Keeping those eyes fixated. Moving only the head around the eyeballs. Good, nice job, you guys. Keep it smooth and steady. You're doing great. Keep the breath moving, and let's do a couple more. Nice work. One more up, one more down. Come back to the center. Release, close the eyes, and give yourself a break. Nice, nice job, you guys. Let's go ahead with the eyes still closed. Let's take a breath to reset. Inhale through the nose, pull the air in. Open mouth, let it all go. Awesome, awesome job, you guys. Go ahead, open those eyes back up when you're ready. I'm gonna go ahead, rehydrate, take a sip of water. Feel free to do the same. All right, you guys, so I'm going to come closer to you once more, and we are going to finish off with mouth exercises. So no different than bicep curls, eye muscles, calf muscles, right? All of the muscles we need to move, facial and mouth muscles are no different. So in order to chew, to smile, to eat, to talk, all of those things, we need mouth and tongue muscles. So we'll start off by just giving those muscles a little massage here, right? Maybe you're just doing it with one hand, getting into the muscles of the jaw and the cheeks, maybe right around the ears where they attach. Just giving them a little bit of a rest, warming them up, loosening them up. No different than maybe stretching out the neck or the shoulders. So good, you guys. Okay, so this first one that we're gonna do, we're just gonna open our mouth as wide as possible and then release, right? So open it wide and then release. Good, let's do about 10 of those. Open wide and release. So
So good, you guys. Keep it going. I just realized I'm doing my hands with it. Hands are optional. Just make sure your mouth is opening nice and wide. Last one, nice and big. Open those mouths and release. Ah, nice job, you guys. If you need to give it a little massage or a little love in between each exercise, feel free. All right, so the next one, always my favorite, just smiling, right? So we're gonna smile really big and then release. Really focus on pulling the corners of the mouths away from each other, up towards the cheeks, and relax. Good, smile and release. Nice job. Feel free to show teeth or no teeth. I think we've discussed how there's two types of people, those who show their teeth and those who don't in pictures. And my family is a divided house for sure. Nice job, you guys. One more big smile and release. So good. Who knew smiling could be so difficult sometimes? All right, we're gonna do another one with smiles, but then we're gonna alternate it with puckers. So like we're kissing, right? So feel free to make the kissy noises or not, but pull those lips together and stick them straight out. And then smile. Good, pucker out. And smile. Good, keep it going. Pull those lips in and stick them out. And smile. Nice job, you guys. Keep it going. A couple more just like that. Good. Last one. One more big pucker and a big smile. You guys are doing awesome. So, so good. No different. Take a break if you need. Take some water if you need. These mouth muscles can get really kind of crampy and tight when you start to focus on them. So just take it at your pace, okay? All right, this next one I'm going to describe to you and then I'll show to you. So what we want to do, keeping our lips nice and sealed, we're going to puff our cheeks up just like a pufferfish. Yeah, blowfish, pufferfish. And then with our cheeks full of air, we're going to push the air side to side. So it looks something like this. Good, so, so good. So the important part is that you keep those lips sealed and try not to let any air come out as you're pushing them. If you're using one hand, it's gonna look a little like this. So, so good, you guys. Keep it going, just shifting that air side to side while keeping the lips sealed. You should definitely feel some pressure and it will require you to hold those lips even tighter together. Let's go ahead and do one more. Awesome work, you guys. You are doing so good. All right, this next one, let's see if we can make some really loud lip smacks, right? So I always gotta lick my lips a little bit here. Seal them together and smack them wide open. Let's go ahead. Try and make it nice and loud. You guys are doing so good. Let's finish off with just a couple more. Last one. Awesome job. You guys are doing great. All right. The next two, we're going to focus on the tongue. So the important part here is that you are controlled with your tongue movements. So the first one we're going to do is open our mouth and take our tongue side to side like this. Good. If you can do it to the beat of the song, more power to you. But make sure you keep it nice and controlled. If you want to go faster, you can, right? But if your tongue starts to go in different directions, slow it down and really focusing on hitting each corner of the mouth. Nice work, you guys. That's so good. All right, this next one is going to take the tongue up and down. So same thing, you can go fast if it's controlled. If the tongue starts going in different directions, slow it down and just keep it nice and controlled so it goes up towards your nose and then back down towards your chin. Nice work, you guys. Keep it going. Do a couple more just like that. Awesome, awesome job. You never really think, oh, I got to work out my tongue or I got to do bicep curls with my tongue. But again, think about it. Talking, drinking, eating, all those things require all these muscles in our mouth and our tongue. So no different. We got to keep it strong and get that endurance up. All right, these next two, or we only have two left, but this next one requires a little bit of explanation. So just listen up and then I'll try to show you. You want to bite your tongue gently with your teeth. And then while your tongue is clamped down, try to swallow, right? So it looks something like this. And the little head nod of mine is indicating that I'm swallowing. So go ahead and try it. This one's definitely a little bit more challenging. Take it nice and slow. If you need a sip of your water, feel free to do that. Whew, nice job, you guys. You're over halfway there. Let's do a couple more. Ah, so, so good, you guys. Oh, man, that one definitely tires me out. So make sure you're keeping an eye on how you're feeling, tune in with your body, and take rest as you need to. All right, one last one. And it's kind of hard to frown during this song, but that's the exercise. So we're gonna frown big and then swallow. Good, frown and then swallow. Keep it going, you guys. Maybe a little dance to it. Like I said, though, it's hard to frown during this song. So maybe just stick to strictly business. No dancing until this is over. Frown. And then swallow. Nice job, you guys. Let's do about two more of those. Ah. Oh man, you guys, so, so good. But guess what? You made it, all done, nice job. I appreciate you guys coming back, focusing on the strength, focusing on the endurance. You guys are doing so good with this class and I think we're having a lot of fun with it. So thanks so much for joining as always. We will be back tomorrow morning for morning mindfulness at 10 a.m. and then again at 1:30 for another round of rehabilitative strengthening. So. Oh my goodness, before we leave, let's take a couple clearing breaths, right? How could I forget? Go ahead, take a nice cleansing breath in. Open mouth, exhale. Good, two more, just like that. Inhale, and exhale. And last one, deep breath in, and exhale. Awesome, awesome job, you guys. You did so great. Again, thank you for joining, and we hope to see you guys again next time. Take care.